Tom Thumb. Once upon a time, there lived a very wise wizard named Merlin. Even the fairy queen was a friend of his. One day, Merlin knocked at the door of a small cottage and asked for some food. The farmer and his wife not only gave him a bowl of milk with some tasty bread, but they said he could spend the night in their home. Merlin saw that the farmer and his wife were very sad. "Why are you so sad?" asked Merlin. "Because we have no children. I would be the happiest woman in the world if I had a son. Why, even if he were no bigger than my husband's thumb, we would love him dearly." "That would be a very unique kind of child," said Merlin, "but I hope your wish comes true." Then Merlin went on his way to visit the queen of the fairies. He told the fairy the wish of the farmer's wife. The queen said, "The good woman shall have her wish. A son the size of her husband's thumb." People came from far and wide to see the famous tiny boy. One day, the fairy queen kissed the little boy and named him Tom Thumb. Tom got into quite a bit of mischief. One day, his mother was mixing a cake. Tom leaned over the edge of the bowl and fell in. Tom kicked and kicked inside the batter, and it moved and tossed about. His mother was afraid. "There must be gremlins in it," she said. She went to the window to throw the batter out. Just then, a poor beggar was passing by. "Here is some batter you may have." The beggar thanked her and took it. He had not gone very far when Tom shouted, "Take me out!" The poor beggar was so frightened that he ran off. Tom ran home where his mother put him to bed. Another time, Tom's mother took him to milk the cow. So she wouldn't lose him, she tied him to a piece of hay. The cow took the wisp of hay into her mouth. She began to chew and chew. Tom began to jump and shout. He frightened the cow and Tom jumped out. Fortunately, he was not hurt. One day, Tom was in the field helping his father. "Let me drive the horse home," said Tom. "How could you hold the reins?" "I could stand in the horse's ear and tell him which way to go," said Tom. So his father put him in the horse's ear, and he got them home safely. His mother kissed him and gave him a plump blueberry for supper. Tom tried to drive the cows, but he fell into a deep ditch. There, a great bird saw him and thought he was a mouse. The bird seized Tom in her claws and carried him toward her nest. As they were passing over the sea, Tom fell into the water, where a great fish swallowed him. The fish was caught, and it was such a big one that it was sent to the king. When the cook cut open the fish, out jumped Tom Thumb. Tom was brought before the king, and he told his story. The king grew very fond of Tom, and took Tom with him wherever he went. The king had a new suit made for Tom, and gave him a needle for a sword. The king and queen never tired of seeing him. One day, as they were going hunting, a cat jumped out. Tom drew his needle sword and tried to drive the cat away. Tom was scratched and bitten badly, but he did not die. Soon he was well again and did many brave deeds to please the king. And several times a year, the king took Tom to see his parents, for he always loved his dear mother and father.